Attending the Montreal Thematic Conference on Metropolitan Areas is Dr. Janice Perlman. I'm in her company. I'm delighted to be able to talk to her. She's an urban anthropologist, a research scholar, a consultant, and a lecturer specializing in global urbanization, marginalization, and the importance of personhood. Welcome.
Thank you.
Delighted to meet you. Metropolitan areas. A larger proportion of people are living in metropolitan areas. They're becoming bigger, vaster. So how do local populations, civil organizations, become interested in what is a metropolitan area? How do they identify with this area?
Well, so far that's been very difficult, and the concept of metropolitan area for especially the poor and marginalized has been rather vague. In fact, many of them have never even gone outside of their own neighborhood into other parts of the city. So what's happening now, for example, in Rio de Janeiro is an example of giving people a stake in their future by linking it to the future of the metropolitan area. And one example that I love in Rio is that the youth, who have always felt even more excluded, the youth who were low income, have made a common cause between the ones who live in favelas or the squatter settlements in Rio and the ones who live in the poor suburbios, the outlying, really unserved neighborhoods. And they have decided to unite together to create a stronger voice pushing for the rights to the city and their rights to personhood, but they've done it at the metropolitan region level because they say that the level of the municipality is too small, and they come from many different municipalities, and the level of the state is too rural, because a lot of the state of Rio is not in the urban area. Okay. So the metropolitan region is the urbanized area, which is the focus of their future, and they are working on a plan for 2017 that the youth will put forward for the metropolitan region.
So they found a key to belonging, to identifying with this region.
Exactly. They found a key to putting this regional territory on their own map within their own identities of their own communities, using culture and the history of their communities, and responding to a new advisory council that's at the metropolitan level in the government.
Okay. Now, you've done lots of work on the favelas of Brazil. We know you've written extensively on the subject of exclusion and big cities. How do you promote integration? I know this is a big question, but how do you promote it?
Well, I think there are two things that make people really feel integrated. And one is the equal standing in front of the law in that city. So usually people of color or people who are young or people who are in informal settlements don't feel like full citizens. They don't feel that they really have the same rights. So it's not only the right to housing and the right to the city, but it's the right to be treated with dignity and respect. And I think a very interesting example of this is that because the Brazilians have a law called the Statute of the City, and in that law, it gives them the right to the city, but some poor people from remote settlements in São Paulo invaded and lived in an abandoned office building and won a court case, not only based on the right to the city, but the right to the central city, because they argued that their children could not get access to good education, they couldn't get access to good health care, and they couldn't get access to the job market, living 2.5 or 3 hours outside. And so they actually won that case. So the first thing is like what kind of citizenship can be given to people who are living in the territory of the metropolitan area that gives them a sense of belonging. And the second one is giving them voice. How can they be heard and how can it be proven that their position is taken into account?
Excellent. Thank you so much for this, Dr. Perlman.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.